morning, everyone. Welcome to the second week of our yoga series. It is just me this morning, aside from the dog Hallie, who might make an appearance. I am going to take you through a 30-minute practice again. I'll review a little bit of what we did last week as we go, give you some refreshers, and then we will move into some new poses and some new movements that we didn't do last week. So I hope you all enjoy, and as always, only do what feels good. It feels good to just lay on your mat. It feels good to just do sun salutations. If it feels good to, I don't know, do downward dog. Do whatever feels good. Don't push yourself. Don't ever do anything that hurts or makes you uncomfortable. We want this practice to really be for you and for you to feel good. And if you're like me and you're practicing outside when it's 30 degrees, make sure you have lots of water and a towel or something to practice on. So, first I want to remind us of last week. We learned an integral series, Sun Salutation A. And today we are going to build on that and come into some Sun Salutation Bs. So if we remember from last week, when we're standing in mountain pose, that's the top of the mat, and your core is tight and kind of tilted under, and you're strong. And I know it looks like you're just standing, but if I made you stand here for 5 minutes, trust me, you would really feel it. So we inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold through heart center. Inhale, lengthen. Go for a flat back. Exhale, hands to the mat. High plank or low plank. All the way down. And here you can do baby cobra, where you should be able to lift your hands off. Or upward facing dog. Then exhale to downward facing dog. Then we either walk or step back to the top of our mat. So that's our Sun A, and I'll walk you through it when we do it in the sequence, but I want you to remember that and build on that today. So, start our practice. We're going to come down on our backs into Supta Baddha Konasana, which is just the fancy name or the yogi name for laying on your back in butterfly pose. So if I ever say the yogi names of poses, you don't need to learn them. They're Sanskrit, they're the traditional names. But I'll always explain what the pose is or call the English name for it, because those are what you really will hear mostly when you're practicing yoga or if you're doing it. I mean, it makes sense, but it really isn't going to give us a leg up on anything. So I'll make sure that it's clear. So if this pose isn't comfortable for you, remember you can lay your knees together and your feet apart on the mat. Or you can just lay straight. Really, do whatever feels good. And if it's a bit too much of a stretch, you can even cross your legs. And put one hand on your stomach and one on your chest. And just breathe normally. This is your time to kind of get rid of any thoughts that aren't serving you and just relax. You're going to get 30 minutes to just follow along, get a little movement, and relax. in to one of those great hugs. And kind of move your knees. Do whatever feels good there. And you're going to, you can either extend that left leg out and twist over. Or that might feel a little too intense, so you can keep your knees together and just drop them to the left. You want to look over your right shoulder. Make sure you're twisting from the middle of your spine. Side to side, whatever feels good, and then drop your knees or knee, whichever variation you chose, to the right. Again, your gaze is over your left shoulder with this. Really feeling it start in that mid spine, twist out, dropping the left shoulder onto the mat, and the right knee is down to the right. Come back to center. You can just straighten those legs up high, move them out, shake them out a little. Good. And when you're ready, start rocking back and forth. You feel that rock really go all the way down your spine and help you loosen up. And on your last rock, come across your feet and into tabletop. So here we have our knees under our hips, hands under our shoulders, and we're going to inhale, draw and look up, exhale, really curve that spine. And just flow through these, really stretching out. You can make some figure eights with your hips, your shoulders. Do what feels good to open up those shoulders. Tabletop. We're going to do a little bit of core here. So we're going to start just by raising the right arm up and holding. And keep your core tight. And back down. Now your left arm raise. Good. Now your right knee up. Back. You don't want to kind of fling it up in the air. You want to keep it as close to square as you can. And down. And left leg. Good. Now, if you want a little challenge, we're going to go right hand, left leg. And extend them out and bring them into me. Good. Inhale again. Bring them out So we inhale them up. Exhale them together. Inhale. Good, and down. Now we're just going to push ourselves back. Feel that stretch on your toes, your Achilles, and your lower calves. So this is an area we don't really stretch a lot, but it's so good for you to stretch the bottom of your feet and the lower legs. Especially when you're about to go into a down dog and start your sequence. Into child's pose for a second. We're going to start in on our sun salutation A's, and we're going to do two of those to start to warm our bodies up and get moving. When you're ready, push up into downward facing dog. And step to the top of your mat. So here we're gonna inhale, swoop up. Do a little back bend. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, high plank. And you can go from your high plank down or bring it to your low plank. Inhale, up dog or baby cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Pedal the feet here. Good. We're going to step or hop on the next exhale. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, high to low plank. Up dog or baby cobra. And downward facing dog. Two breaths here. Then come into pose again. Remember from last week, you can separate your knees out if you want that hip stretch, and you can bring them in. That lengthens the spine. Or if those aren't comfortable, you can come to puppy pose. Okay. So for our next one, it's going to be similar to a sun A, but, and you can stay in your child's pose while I talk. It's going to start with a squat position called, well, we'll get to that. So you're going to start in your squat position, then you're going to be stepping back into two powerful poses, one on your right, one on your left, called Warrior One. These are really going to work your quads, work your feet, even your shoulders with your arm position. And they're really a powerful pose and a grounding pose. So make sure you take the time to feel that pose, listen to the instruction on where your body should be, and enjoy it. So, when you're done in child's pose, come back to tabletop. Good. push up to downward facing dog. Good. And step or hop to the top of your mat. We're going to come into Utkatasana. Chair pose. So you sweep your hands up and you sit back, just like you're sitting in your chair. Good. So you're working those quads, your core is tucked, you're sitting down. Make sure you're breathing, moving your shoulders away from your ears. Good. Hold for one more inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, high or low plank. Remember to do what feels good. Up dog or baby cobra. And downward facing dog. So from here, you're going to sweep your right leg up. And then step it through. So right between your hands, step that right foot through. Bring your left heel down. And arms sweep up. So you have a bend in the front leg. And your heel in the front is aligned with the back. Your back leg is strong. Good. Use those strong fingers. You're pulling your left hip forward, right hip back, keeping them square. So you can see how I'm lined up here, square to the front. Good. Inhale up, exhale, fold. And you're going to go your high plank or low and flow through. Inhale up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale your left foot up and step it through. Front heel and back heel aligned. Your back foot is at a 45 degree angle. So it's kind of like that. Good. Hips pivoting forward. Good. Shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. And here you can go through your high plank to low plank. Or just meet in downward facing dog. And come to child's pose once again. We're going to come back to downward dog, and we're going to go through one extended sun salutation B series, and I'll walk you through it, but it's going to involve your chair pose and your warriors, and it's going to really warm you up, especially if you're outside or in a warm room in the summer we've been having. So come to downward facing dog. On your next exhale, step or hop to the top of the mat. And inhale to chair pose. Utkatasana. You can even bring your hands out. Feel all that power and heat building up in your body. Two more rounds of breath. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, high to low plank. Up dog or baby cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale your right leg up. You can open your hip a little if that feels good. Then step through. Warrior one. Now shimmy your foot a little bit to the left, your right foot, so that your heel is lined up to your arch, your back foot, and go to warrior two. So you're looking over your front middle finger, still have that nice 90 degree you're trying to get here. Strong, high haul, welcome back, sorry for the quick scene change. We're going to pick up where we left off in our Sun Salutation B. So this is going to be the extended Sun Salutation B. So we're going to inhale up, exhale to Utkatasana. Good. Sitting low. Bring your hands to a power handstand. So like this, and you're keeping your shoulders strong, pushing those hands out. With each inhale, you lengthen up, and exhale as you sit lower. Baby cobra and downward facing dog. Kick your right foot up and you can open your hip a little if that feels good. Step through, warrior one. Heels are aligned, hands come up. Warrior two. So your front foot comes into center a little bit. So your front heel is lined up with your back arch. Arms are level. Gaze is over your front middle finger. Good. Flip your front palm. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Breathe into that right side. Exhale, bring your front elbow to your front quad. Left arm comes up, so it's an extension of the back leg, extended side angle. Bring your gaze up for a little challenge. Inhale to warrior two. Exhale, windmill the hands back to downward facing dog. And inhale that left leg up and open. Exhale, step. Just gonna switch sides so that I'm not facing you with my back. Come to warrior two. So front heel, back arch, arms are strong. You really feel that front quad work. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, extended side angle. You don't want to be totally leaning, you could lift this arm. It's just gently there. What a challenge. You can go both arms off. Good. Inhale, warrior two. And windmill your hands. Back to down dog. Walk your hands and feet to meet each other in the middle of your mat. We're going to come into our balancing poses now. So we'll start with tree pose that we did last week. You want to ground down with that left foot. Lift your right foot off. Open the hip. And you bring that foot either below or above the knee joint. You never want it right there, pushing out on that knee. So above or below, hands to heart center. Inhale back to center. Exhale down. Shake it out and ground down through that right foot. Same thing on the left, above or below the knee joint. You can extend your arms if that feels good. Exhale to standing. Good. Today we're going to try a different balancing pose called Eagle. And Eagle has two parts. So there's a leg part and an arm part. And honestly, the hardest part of this pose is getting the right leg over and the right arm under. So we're going to learn the arms first. So you're going to take... If we're going to start with our right leg, it's going to go over, right arm under. So take your right arm and bring it under your left elbow. Then bring your hands together so that you're forming a twist. And some people this is easy for, some people it's hard for. The other option is to bring them together like this. For the legs, you're going to bring both feet together. You're going to sit low. And you're going to bring that right leg over. And the goal is to wrap these toes around the back of your calf. Again, super easy for some, super hard for others like me. Arms are easy for me, legs, not so much. So if you're finding it hard to balance on your legs, you can also just bring that foot over and see how your toes are touching. And if that helps you get lower, it's worth it. So don't hesitate to take a variation and do what feels good. So we're going to inhale up, exhale, Utkatasana. Now you're going to bring your right arm under, right leg over, and take whatever variation feels good. This or this. And on your inhale, bring your elbows up. Exhale, sit lower. Take two more big rounds of breath. And get a little lower. And last exhale. Good. This time you're going to ground with the right leg, left leg over. Left arm under. This side can be much better or much worse. It depends on what type of body you have and what type of day you're having, really. So, inhale, exhale, left leg over, after I'm under. This one's much easier on the arms for me, much harder on the legs. Inhale those elbows a little higher, exhale a little lower. Last inhale. And come to standing. Good. Sweep up, exhale, fold. Oh, yeah. Inhale, halfway lift. Now exhale yourself down and bring your legs, your feet as wide as the mat. You're just going to come into a low squat. So for some, this is comfortable. Others are much more flexible, your feet can be closer. Some, this is gonna be what feels best for you. Choose your variation. You can push those knees out for a little extra stretch in your hips there. Seated position. Good. Now plant those feet here and using your core, arms up, lower down on a 5 count. 5, 4, feel that core. 3, 2, and 1. Those heels in so you can just touch them. Arms like a robot. Inhale your hips up. You can work to clasp underneath. That feels good. Inhale up. Exhale down. Just a second there. We're going to do one more. There's also the option, I'm not going to demonstrate it because I don't want anyone pushing too hard into it, but a wheel or a back bridge, and you push up and you make almost like a C facing the ground. If you know how to do that and you feel comfortable, please feel free to go there. If not, we'll work our way up to that with more classes. Inhale up to wheel, or your hips up. Inhale up. Exhale down. Good. Roll over to your side. Push yourself up to sitting. This one we're just going to do a nice little butterfly stretch to finish off. So bring your feet together, knees fall apart. You're just going to hold your feet, gently pull yourself forward. Good. Feel it in your hips and your low back. You can push those knees down if it feels better. Exhale, get a little bit deeper. And inhale up. Good. While you're seated, take a little time just to stretch that neck side to side. Do a few little rolls. onto our back for Shavasana. Well, take up as much space as you can. Yourself a little body scan from top to bottom. Do you need to direct your breath anywhere to feel a little more relaxation? Get rid of some tension. Feel yourself melting into the mat. Feel every part of your body giving in and letting go. These are just a few minutes that are just for you. Just for your body. Take a nice big breath in. Exhale, let yourself melt into your mat a little more. Ready, roll onto your side and push yourself up into a seated position. Good. Bring your hands to heart center. And we acknowledge each other and thank each other for practicing today by saying, the light within me acknowledges the light within you. Namaste. I'll see you next week.